What's going on? Hope everyone's doing well. Today we're gonna do things just a little bit different, just a tiny bit. I've only been doing hip-hop albums outside of J. Cole's Might Delete Later. That's a mixtape. Besides that, every project that I covered on this segment has been an album. This episode is dedicated to a mixtape this time. I think it's a cool idea to do albums and mixtapes, so I'm gonna start throwing in mixtapes in between all the albums that I do. I'm going to critique it in a different way because of that. It's not really fair to critique an album as if it's a mixtape. The rubric for it is gonna be slightly different. What I'm looking for and how I'm rating the album is gonna be completely different compared to an album, because albums and mixtapes, especially in the hip-hop world, are very different from each other. Mixtapes are more like a group of songs that are maybe, I wouldn't say unfinished, but you have like a bunch of songs that are in the vault that you maybe want to like go over later on. You want to throw a project out there, basically a mixtape, right? So you're going to take those type of songs and put them together into like a compilation project where you're just getting a bunch of random songs. None of the songs have like any connection with each other. That's how I would explain the difference between a mixtape and an album. And in an album, it's a lot more serious. It's sort of like a book, or like you're making a movie where you have the title of the album and all the songs in the album represent the title in a way where it's almost like you're giving a story to the listener as if it's a book or something like that. That's what an album means to me. So I'm gonna critique the mixtape as if it's a mixtape. I'm not gonna like take a mixtape, put it on this video and critique it as if it's an album, because that'd be so unfair. I'd most likely give it bad ratings because mixtapes are a group of random songs compared to like an album where the artist is paying way more attention to each song. They're taking it a lot more serious. There's a lot more going on. Every song's kind of connected with each other to like create the album. Today, we're gonna do the new mixtape by Denzel Curry, King of the Mischievous South, Volume 2. This is the sequel to a project that he did a few years ago. I can't remember like when he dropped the original one, but this is a sequel to the original. 15 tracks on this one. He released this one August 19th. This is a mixtape. Like I said, this is a mixtape, so I'm gonna critique it in a mixtape way. I'm not gonna critique it as an album. Denzel Curry, one of the best rappers to come out of Florida, Miami, Florida, longtime rapper, but still pretty young. I think he's like 27 or 28 now, but in Florida, Miami, Florida, with guys like Space Ghost Perp, Chris Travis, Xavier Wolf, another part of the crew, various other members that I can't really think of right now, but this is a collective that started out Miami, Florida. I'm pretty sure Space Ghost Perp is the main person behind it. I think he started it. He started to add more members, producers, rappers. Denzel Curry might have been one of his homies growing up, and that's how he got involved with it. He's one of the original members of Raider Clan, just been going on a tear with his solo career. Even though he's 28, he's probably had a longer career than a lot of rappers that you see in the game today. Very skilled rapper. I think he's one of the best rappers to ever do it. I have him on my 104 list. He has that like Florida sound, you know what I mean? He's from Florida, so you know he's gonna sound like he's from Florida. Kind of has that like 3-6 Mafia type of sound, and a lot of that underground hip-hop coming out of Memphis, Tennessee back in the days, way before the 2000s, maybe like a little bit before the 2000s. He is able to take that sound, rearrange it in his own style, and in a lot of ways he sort of made it better in my opinion. Especially guys like Space Ghost Perp, sort of like an underground trap style, cloud rap, you could even say, you can add cloud rap to that. He revamped it into something so incredible that you see a lot of younger rappers coming up that are sort of trying to mimic the style. Denzel Curry, one of those rappers that I sort of grew up listening to, definitely taking notes from his style. This new mixtape here, King of the Mischievous South Volume 2. He's made a lot of mixtapes in his career. He's got a lot of mixtapes, got I think more than 10. He's a mixtape type of rapper. When he does put his mixtapes together, you're usually getting the best out of Denzel Curry, even though his albums are pretty crazy too. You can't really compare a lot of rappers to him too. Very different style. The way he raps is just crazy, man. Like he can go super fast with the syllables and then he can slow it down and make both styles sound really good. He can sell both styles very well. We're about to break down this mixtape. same format, just like I do with albums, but everything is just based off of the mixtape. I'm gonna rate it as a mixtape, talk about it as a mixtape. I'm sort of gonna rate it based off of how good every song is, more so than how great of a project it is as a whole, through the mixtape lens, not the album lens. So like, it's really important to understand that before we go over this project and I give you my rating about it, my point of view. So Denzel Curry, the king of The Mischievous Volume 2. We're about to go over a couple of the tracks on the mixtape to give you guys an idea of how it sounds like. Then I'm gonna start breaking it down based off of my viewpoints, how I feel about the mixtape, how good or bad it is. I'm gonna give you guys a rating afterwards out of 10. Just gonna go over some of the music that I'm gonna release for the future. The next track that I'm dropping, this one's called Magneto. This one's set for August 24th. The next single I'm dropping, check that out once I drop it. Listen to Usain Bolt. That's the most recent song that I've put out. The next project that I'll be releasing, this is a mixtape. This one's called Hashtag Indica. It's a 15-track mixtape. This one's set for October 4th. That's the official day for this mixtape. 15-track project. Once I drop it, you guys absolutely have to listen to this one. The best project that I've released so far this year. Hopefully you guys see it the same way. We're gonna get right into it. This one's called G's Up. The next track, this one's called Skeed. You was a fluke, I'm like a bitch like a fluke, with all the shit that I seen, this one is so sick as a fluke, treating my people like animals, bitch, I grew up in a zoo, the next one, this one's Set It. I think I gotta play one more. So this one, next one I'll play, this one's called Wishlist. King of the Mischievous Volume 2 by Denzel Curry. Like I was saying earlier, he's one of my favorite rappers, especially out of like the new school, best like young rappers in the game right now. Out of all of the rappers that are under the age of 30, let's put it that way. Out of all the rappers that are under the age of 30, Denzel Curry is top 5. His lyrical game is just like, he's one of the few rappers that can do every style, that's mastered his own style to a point where it's like even his freestyles will sound like verses that he wrote. He's that type of rapper. His performance game is ridiculous. I think he can make beats too. After saying all of that, he's definitely had better mixtapes in the past, in my opinion. As a longtime fan of Denzel Curry, just the fact that I've heard a lot of the music that he's made in the past, a lot of the mixtapes that he's dropped in the past, he's made a lot of mixtapes and songs in the past that would definitely outdo the music that you hear on this mixtape. Half of the songs on the mixtape were made really well. He's got a lot of club bangers on there, and also lyrical joints where he's kind of going on like a spaz with his rhymes and, you know, doing his thing, rapping with the quick syllables and giving you all of these like punchlines that you will never hear from any other rapper, because like I said, his style is pretty distinctive too. Even the way he comes up with his metaphors, he has a very like strange mind for coming up with different like metaphors. Just how his mind works is very different from most rappers, the way they come up with their metaphors. When you hear a metaphor and a simile from Denzel Curry, it's gonna always be something super different from any other metaphor or simile that you hear from other new school rappers. So he has that type of like superpower when it comes to rapping, but he doesn't really display that well on this project, this mixtape. He's had mixtapes in the past that are far better than what he did on this one. I don't know, like, I think half of the mixtape is very strong. I think there's 15 tracks on here. I think two of them are skits, so we'll say 13 tracks. Maybe 7 out of the 13 are tracks that I would put in my own rotation in terms of like music that I personally listen to. He makes like a lot of cruising around music on this mixtape, and it's all the good tracks on it. All the tracks that I didn't really like too much on it weren't so bad, but there's just like underwhelming and just way weaker than what you're used to hearing from Denzel Curry. Just not typical Denzel Curry, where this guy is going on a lyrical like spaz, and the beats are like super futuristic, very strong at the same time, like heavy beats, heavy bass. The drum pattern is very like heavy and like hard hitting. There's a lot of beats on here that are like that. Half of the songs are good and the other half are just like okay or maybe less than okay. So that's kind of how I felt on this mixtape. I think volume one was a lot better. I think it was a little more consistent throughout. He gave his full attention on half of the mixtape, and then on the other half, a lot of throwaway songs. Songs he could have definitely just thrown away. He could have kept the mixtape at like maybe 8 tracks, maybe add another 2 or 3 better songs. I would have praised this mixtape a lot more, and the rating that I'm about to give it would be a lot higher if it was that case. I got no complaints about the features on this one. It could have been a little more consistent in terms of making every track as good as each other, instead of making half of the mixtape really strong and then kind of slowing down on the other half. Like, when you listen to the mixtape from track one to the last one, it's not like the first half is really strong and then the second half is bad. And it's not like the second half is really strong and the first half is like really bad. That's the case most of the time with albums, especially hip-hop albums. On this one, it's more like all the good songs are mixed up with all the bad songs. So you get like the first 2 songs are like okay, and then I think the 3rd song's a banger, and then the 4th song's just okay, and then the next 2 songs are pretty good, and then it's kind of like that. I'm not the biggest fan of skits. I think it's like an old style of like decorating an album when it comes to hip-hop music, and a lot of rappers still do it to this day, and it doesn't bug me too much, you know what I mean? Skits don't bug me too much. Just like, the only thing is like, they're not like songs, they're skits. For me, it's a little bit better if you were to mesh the skit with the song, so that all the tracks on the mixtape are legitimately songs. You'll get the skit after the song's done, you know what I mean? It's a part of the track, rather than making the skits like a track. Yeah, if you get what I'm saying. So like, when you're putting skits in your mixtapes or albums, I think it's better to like mix them with the tracks rather than separating them from the track and making it its own individual track. You get what I'm saying? It's a little annoying when artists do that with their albums and mixtapes. It's Denzel Curry. He's super creative. He'll find like a creative way to do it no matter what. So it's not so much of a problem when Denzel Curry does it compared to other rappers. But I think it could have been a little bit better if he didn't involve as many skits as he did. That doesn't really turn the rating down. That's another thing to mention. This is a mixtape, not an album. So it's a little bit weird to critique this one after doing so many albums. I'm trying my best not to critique it like it's an album. The highlight songs that I actually enjoyed on it, I think were pretty good for the most part. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else I can say about this mixtape. It gives you a lot of 3-6 Mafia vibes, a lot of Juicy J, Project Pat vibes, which is really cool. It's not like a huge surprise that the mixtape sounds the way it does. In terms of a rating, I'm giving this one an 8 out of 10. In terms of a mixtape rating, I think the songs that I do like on here are very strong. Maybe I won't remember so much, not super memorable, but just cool to hear. At the time, definitely songs that you'd want to hear live if you ever went to a Denzel Curry show. You know, nice strong performance from Denzel Curry. Kind of just did his thing, you know. Nothing to like shake you, you know what I mean? You're not like, oh shit, like you gotta listen to this mixtape. Like it doesn't make you go crazy, you know what I'm saying? Like 8 out of 10, Denzel Curry, King of the Mischievous, Volume 2. Let me know down below if you would give it a higher rating, you know what I mean? If this mixtape was good, if you enjoyed it yourself. If not, what rating you would give it, let me know down below. Like the video, subscribe too. I really appreciate you guys watching. Of course, once again, I'm Looper Norris. I'll be back with more of these videos. I got another one of these videos for the week. I'm trying to do 2 of them every week. Plenty of content on the way, of course. Got more music on the way. Make sure you check out Magneto, set for August 24th. That's the next single that I'll be dropping. The new mixtape, hashtag Indica, 15-track mixtape. That one's set for October 4th. Check that out once I drop it, man. Plenty more music after the mixtape. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.